to the Foundation, guys. We've been joined by Emily, and a bunch of the FBC crew makes us feel a little less alone in here, which I'm not sure I'm a fan of, but we've got lovely Emily here with us now. We can have a little chat to her about everything here, I guess. Nice to see you out of the office, Emily.
What are you doing down here, Emily? What do you mean? You called me down, remember? I'm pretty sure I didn't. No, that's right. You didn't. But then, I remember you needing me to come here. I mean, you even told me how to get in. Let's just chalk it up to synchronicity so we can get to work.
She takes everything in stride.
The board called me down here to deal with the situation. The astral plane is colliding with our world. I know, isn't it fascinating? I never even considered that the astral plane could be a physical volume expanding beyond its dimensional container. The bleed is localized to this area, but its growth rate seems steady. Given time, it will consume the entire Bureau, and possibly beyond. That's what I'm here to stop. The board told me to fix the nail over there by dismantling four locks in the astral plane. Funny, I think it's put itself back together a bit. So that could be due to the law of inverse exchange. For every associated component you remove, this nail reconstructs. Or possibly some variation of anti-sympathy. Don't worry, I'll look into it. Did you notice all the Bureau infrastructure? It looks like there was a research team stationed down here at some point. Do you think Darling knew about this?
I'd put money on it. That reminds me, have you seen Marshall? She contacted me over the hotline, but then I saw her walking around.
I haven't seen her. The hotline only connects to extraplanar entities. Or dead people. But Marshall's proved time and time again that she's a survivor.
Yeah, about that.
That's exactly what I thought.
Anyway, I've been looking into the minerals growing down here. Have you noticed how they insist on maintaining a certain form? Maybe some sort of a state memory, or they consciously prefer a certain shape?
I think we're on a clock here, Emily. I need to stop the astral bleeding before it brings the oldest house down. See what you can find out from the nail in the meantime. And send out some rangers to look for Marshall. She may be in trouble.
Will do, Jesse.
Nah, she's dead.
If you see anything interesting, remember to take detailed notes.
Okay, thanks. Pope's collection. What is that? She does sound a lot like Emma Stone. That's what I was thinking then when she was talking, the way she pronounces certain things. Just talk to her again. Okay. Alright, I don't see why we can't talk to Emily now for a bit. Games always try and put time pressure on you when there's no need.
Jesse, you're back. So did you find anything noteworthy? The original Bureau expedition down here left so much interesting stuff behind.
Like their ID cards. I picked up a weird one. It's pretty old.
Oh wow, look at that. Yeah, I found a few ID cards myself. Or more accurately, the Rangers found them for me.
Are you starting a collection?
I'm going for the whole set. I kid, of course. But I suppose they are sort of like baseball cards, except for Bureau stuff from the 60s.
Who are dead, probably.
The one you found is different than mine. It looks like it's a higher clearance level.
A rare one, then. Want to keep it, Emily?
Yeah, I absolutely do. But I think you should hang on to it for now. High clearance access might come in handy.
Sounds like you have something in mind.
Guilty. See, I've been going through Dr. Ash's notes, or the ones I can find, anyway. Like Darling, he seemed to enjoy hiding his most relevant research. From what I gather, there is another floor beneath the warehouse, with a special lab that requires 5 high-level staff members just to access.
Wow.
Here, take this. It's an old skeleton key. Something else the Rangers found. I give them $5 for every useful trinket they bring me.
I'm gonna assume this key is my ticket to that lower floor. And that super secret lab you mentioned.
Bingo bango, as Dr. Darling used to say. Yeah. Keep your eyes peeled for more ID cards around the warehouse.
If Ash's notes are reliable, and I'm sure they are, then 5 is the magic number.
She is a little odd. Well, I guess everyone here is. I just love this shirt. It's like stitched, it's
all
not a separate thing.
The nail keep coming back as nonsense, and a couple of my instruments have already broken.
Maybe we should take that as a sign to pack it in.
I didn't take you for a quitter, Dr. Saba. There's a reason I packed a black rod-plated microscope.
Alright, we'll talk to her again in a second. I just want to have a little look, because we know that this is a dead end. So there's obviously going to be a chest, probably. It is, I swear I'm allergic to this microphone. I haven't, like, sneezed all day until just now. Okay, pretty weak upgrades. Well, that's bizarre that it won't let you through. You can obviously fit through that. Alright, fine. Oh cool, there's like a whole section down below. Interesting. Guess we should check that out too. Yeah, look at all that. Right, let's talk to Emily again because she's got a little thing above her head.
The Rangers have tapped into an old radio network they found around the Foundation. So if you need backup, just call them at one of the stations.
Okay. What's the official history on this place?
How did the Hiss get into the Foundation?
Same way we did, I imagine. But you need to remember that the Hiss are the embodiment of persistence. Their nature seems to be one of force, to find every possible vulnerability and exploit it. Their only goal is consumption.
I'm sure there's plenty of goodies for them down here. The nail, for instance.
If the Hiss could corrupt the nail, I'm sure they would have by now. Hmm. It must not interest them in its broken state. They could be distracted by the numerous unknown paranatural materials I'm sure are lying around. These are the roots of the oldest house. The Hiss will find plenty of ways to make trouble.
Yeah, great.
They're pretty good at that.
Astral Bleed.
So you've never heard of the Foundation, huh?
I've never even seen the name referenced.
Really?
Clearly it's highly classified, but for what reason? The problem with these kinds of closed-off, hidden areas is that they were likely sealed for good reason. But now, no one is left to tell us what that reason was.
Any guesses why the Bureau would hide something like this?
I only know what I've observed. This place is spatially rigid, which means it doesn't shift like the rest of the oldest house.
Hmm.
And before you ask why that is, I have to admit that I'm clueless. There's some signal interfering with my equipment, making it hard to get a clear reading. It's being emitted from the floor. Maybe I should have brought a jackhammer.
The astral plane is already taking chunks out of this place, Emily. Let's not add to it.
She might have been joking, Jesse, but...
So let me get this straight. The astral plane is bleeding into the Foundation.
Correct.
And that's happening because the nail is damaged.
I'd say it's a bit more than damaged, but yes, that is my understanding.
So what's the connection between the nail and the astral plane?
It's a good question. See, I always pictured objects of power as strings between our plane and the astral. If the nail has a similar relationship, then maybe it's more accurate to think of it like plumbing. Now that the nail is busted, sewage is gushing everywhere.
Not the prettiest metaphor.
No.
I should get back out there.
Cheers, Ems.
Agreed. The astral bleed won't stop itself.
All right. Let's decide where we're going to go, because I guess we could drop off the edge here. Oh, that's right in front of us. I guess we could check that out. And then maybe that's the way we're supposed to go, I don't know. We can obviously go. Can we go further up as well? Yeah, look. So we could go that way too. Let's have a little float down here. Big ramps. Really dark. Abyssal almost. This kind of looks like where we did that whole section with Arty. Thought that was going to break then. Can we jump off the edge here? Is it really just a chest down here? Alright, that was a bit of a weird one. I prefer, to be honest, but I prefer being rewarded with lore and stuff for exploration, but no. I don't know, it's always a tricky balance. Like, sometimes I don't like lore being hidden away too much because you feel like it's important for your understanding of the story, but at the same time, I guess it depends on the loot system of the game. I guess the loot isn't very satisfying. Because, you know, you're not finding lots of cosmetics or weapons. It's mostly, like, crafting ingredients that you find in this game. So it's just naturally, it's just not too satisfying unless it's, like, a specific crafting ingredient you definitely know that you need. Anyway. Right. Here we are. I see someone. Right, we've got the little geezers here. No more hiss. Yeah, that looks like the way forwards. Oh, a purple. There's base camp. I like that we can throw forklifts now. Oh no, you don't. Caveman. The bejesus out. Oh. They fight. Oh! Are they fighting each other? Who the hell are you? I need a forklift. Oh, who are you? Right, he's down. Maybe not, actually. Fractured cavern. Oh, where did you come from? Sneaky giant bastard. Alright, that looks destructible. I didn't realize I was a forklift I was throwing there. Okay, lots of paths here. A more official looking FBC section here, actually. Weird. Very weird. But let's have a look around here first. Can't get through here without the other ability or weapon, as it is. Right, is there a way to get up here? Yeah, sure. Okay, so we can't explore that, unfortunately. I should have gone down that optional bit before. I might backtrack now, actually. Why have you respawned? Oh man, I'm sick of the enemies respawning, man. I've got to be honest. It's so frustrating. Alright, not too bad. Dodge efficiency, not really. I just like the flat increases, really, for our energies. Okay. Just stop respawning, man. Please. Please. Not in here, too. Right.
This area looks newer. Is it from the upper floors?
You fool. Base camp? Oh,
there's something behind that hiss barrier.
Collapsed department. There's something over there, like a weird cat or something. Okay, don't know what good that did. Sort of looks moldy. A monitor cut out again. Should perhaps be worried about that. Doesn't happen during other games though, so don't know what's going on. That's too high, man. Yeah, it's one of those waving cats. Symbolizes luck. Come with me, kitty. Oh, come on. Where am I supposed to go? That's bizarre. Oh, maybe I can form a bridge here? Yes. I understand. Still think there's something behind that one because of the bit that says base camp on the map. But got a checkpoint at least. Data entry and filing. Might as well check. Maybe that's the sarcophagus. That's Trench and Darling, right? With... not sure who they're with. Okay, how do I get through? Oh. Shift account part one. To whoever this finds this, I am containment processes designer Jean Gibbs, and I'm writing this to document the largest building shift to ever occur. Here are the facts. Considerably large section of the containment sector, including the processes and protocols offices, our research facilities, and a fair chunk of the firebreak, has been yanked down to a chasm that reaches far below lobby level, I think. It was a violent shift, and I regret to report several casualties. Injuries were sustained by all, but many of us, myself included, are still mobile. We've set up a base camp and started triaging. There are little supplies. We explored our surroundings and found caverns of all things. Maybe we're in some kind of cave threshold, like the quarry. Wherever we are, we're not the first. There were some rusty power cores, old lights, signs, infrastructure. What was this area used for? Why did they seal it off? Why have we never heard of it? More importantly, how are we going to get out? Interesting, so they fell into this classified area by accident due to a building shift. Now, there are no accidents in the oldest house. Keeve, AWE number 37. A series of reverberating sounds observed in downtown Kyiv with no clear point of origin. The event was witnessed by the city's general public. Mental and physical symptoms were reported, including aphasia, sleep paralysis, and excess redacted in the reported individuals. The event response. Due to the brief nature of the event, overseas bureau agents were not able to respond while it was active. Immediately upon arrival, agents collected audio recordings taken by local witnesses. All bureau monitoring stations located at global junctions of acoustic amplification were directed to monitor any auditory events of similar pitch, wavelength, and duration in an effort to trace echoes and epicenters. In the following weeks, similar cases were reported from both various amateur sources and bureau stations in major cities across the globe. The subsequent events diminished in volume and frequency per each occurrence. Event is believed to be generated by planar friction, though this is not confirmed. Wow, it affected a lot of people as well. So this is an old area because they've got punch cards. But maybe they still use them because of the technology regression. Oh no. We're going to need Johnny's help again. I sense. Come on, Johnny. Help me out, mate.
Director Faden here. I need a ranger dispatched to my position.
It's an honor, Director.
Always appreciate the help, John Boy. You work for me now. You go and help Johnny. Ow! You're right, Johnny. How dare you! So I guess this is where the big shift occurred, which is why this is all why this bit is all over the place like this. Alright, Johnny, you hang tight. I'm going to explore this mess that is this area. So this is the collapsed department. We'll have a little scan of everything we just blew up. So many reflections, it's tough to tell where we can go and where we can't. It's a cool fight though, just the way that this is all staged. Oh. Why? No level 3s. You're all banned. Oh, here we go.
You're listening to America Overnight, now in its 29th year. Or is it? It is, don't worry. Tonight, we're discussing thrift store oddities and one-of-a-kind finds.
Yep.
Peggy's on the line from Biloxi.
Come on, Peggy.
Her husband found a beautiful Himalayan salt lamp at a garage sale. Tell us about it, Peggy.
I'd heard of salt lamps, you know, those glowing rocks you plug in. They're supposed to release negative ions. Clear the air? I got one, only $4, and I put it in our living room. I thought it would look nice there. It gives the whole room this lovely orange glow.
Now, this is usually when the call takes a turn.
It's my husband. When he's in the living room, he won't take his eyes off the lamp. He's obsessed with it. If I turn it off, he gets so upset. He says it needs to stay on no matter what. Last night, I woke up at 3 a.m. He wasn't in bed. I found him in the living room staring at the lamp. He was smiling. His eyes were open, but I thought he might be sleepwalking, so I shook him. He just kept smiling at the light. Then he started to speak. He said, every time a reflection reflects itself, it gets a little greener.
I've read that.
And then he turned to me. He was still smiling, eyes open. My husband's eyes are brown, almost black. But the eyes of the man in the living room last night, his eyes were green.
Sounds just like the caterer. Get everything you can out of her and call HQ. Peggy, I'm so sorry to cut you off there, but we need to go to commercial. I'd like you to stay on the line, though. My producer, Karen, needs a little more information. Okay?
Okay.
America Overnight, we'll be right back.
Is this the lamp? Kill it! Let's get out of here, Johnny. That thing's invincible. They're everywhere. Stupid lamp. There's too many little cubby holes here. Right, how do we get out? Something on this side. Maybe? It's a maze. You can just teleport everywhere, Johnny. How do we get out? There we are. Right, thanks for the help, Johnny. Johnny? More enemies just spawned. Possibly. You're on your own, Johnny.
Someone call a plumber.
Sorry to hear that.
Okay, Polaris appeared then. Oh, cool. Oops. Oh. Why does that have to happen? Computer program, it was called. Oh, I'm so upset. I hate missing stuff like this. It was definitely a computer program. Now I'll never know. Come on, man, let me...
I've served under two directors. Three now, I suppose. Trench and I worked our way up together. We made it through the tough cases, the bad days, the casualties. He was the epitome of a good agent. Smart, decisive, selfless.
Really?
And he picked up that damn gun. Becoming director is a formal process overseen by the board. Lots of ritual and mystery. After that, key staff provide detailed briefs on all classified matters, past and present. But with Faden, well, there's no protocol for field promotion. The girl's smart, has a good head on her shoulders. Trusting her to handle the hiss upstairs while I hold them off here. All this shit with the nail, the board, I'm not sure she's ready. Besides, I work better alone.
Yeah, now you're dead. That worked out, didn't it? Top of the world. All right, definitely dangerous in that bathroom. What is that, some sort of meta joke about men's bathrooms being an absolute hellhole? That's how I took it. Yeah, sorry I couldn't find that file again. I'll have to look back at the footage maybe. See what it was actually called. Side rooms. control point. We can't access that, fortunately. Personal mods are full. No level 3s, no level 4s. We're level 5s and 6. We are elitist. No scrubs. Shelter. I was like ready to be jump scared then. Can I blow these up? The hell? How is that black? Cave supplement. Recordings of the audio phenomena were uploaded onto the internet shortly after the event. These records circulated rapidly on popular message boards. The comms department utilized this exposure by creating the Sky Trumpet hoax videos and posting related theories to spread confusion and draw attention away from the event's paranormal origin. Industrial noise, particularly the sound of metal drilling, was found to be a widely accepted explanation. Theories about the sounds emanating from the Earth itself, known as seismic hum, emerged from the public itself and were encouraged by the Bureau to generate further misdirection and eventual public disinterest. Witnesses of the event were monitored discreetly afterwards. Observed symptoms were consistent with redacted deprivation, but subsided after 12 to 15 days. The length of the symptoms directly correlated to the individual's proximity unsheltered to the supposed epicenter. One linked, although accidental, casualty can be listed. Side effects of planar friction on hearing aids. Oh. Sensory deprivation.
You're listening to America Overnight, a beacon in the darkest recesses of possibility for more than 29 years. We have another letter from a listener. This one's unsigned, but postmarked from Toledo. It says, "Dear America Overnight, I have the most wonderful appliance for your listeners. It is a miracle of God. A fondue set. A fountain. A blessed gift. Blessed is spelled with a capital B. Go on," they write. "Dive on in. It is molten hot. Perfect for meat."
Meat?
No signature. As far as I know, no fondue set was sent to us here at the studio. Just this letter. Wait. I think there's something else in the envelope. Some kind of black powder with white shards in it? Bone, maybe? Karen?
On the air, Karen. Where are you?
What is this powder in the booth? Is this ash? Oh God. Karen? How do I cut to commercial?
God. A cannibal fondue set. That's how I read it, heard it. Alright, we're off to the evaluation hall. Shift account part 2. Gibbs, reporting in. It's been 8 days since the collapse and still no sign of any rescue efforts. The Bureau is either completely unaware of our situation or are incapable of helping us. Or maybe it's intentional. How many times have we seen the Bureau not give two shits about its own hardworking staff when they go missing in this place? How many times did we let it slide thinking, oh, at least it wasn't me? Too many, I'm ashamed to admit. Anyway, there have been some developments. Strange crystals have begun growing through the walls. They seem to block some corridors, but not others. The path to the caves is always left open, but we're not sure why. Luckily, the crystals kept out the astral spike. One's been hounding us for days. John, Nikolai, and Sarah went to try and find radio, but never came back. We think the spike got them. Think it's hunting us. Doug says spikes only exist in the astral plane. So what the fuck is it doing here? If we get out of here, I'm hiring a lawyer. These are unsuitable working conditions. Yeah, you don't say, mate. Jesus. Okay, this looks bad. Ba-boom, boom.
Warning. Altered item detected in Transport Bay.
Okay.
Access is prohibited for safety regulation 18.A.
I'm the director. I can fly. Let me in. We'll find a way.
So that's the altered item. Looks pretty secure.
A film camera? Complete the ritual. We're not there yet. Let's see what happens.
No power. Typical.
Okay.
I should hire someone who builds smaller machines.
Okay, how do I get them in though? Very industrial. Thank you.
Personnel may now safely enter. Have a bureau full day.
Destroy them! Possess him, Jesse! Oops. Killed my own minion. Rank amateur. Okay, what do we do from here? I have completely... I have no idea what I'm supposed to do now. Maybe the doors have unlocked upstairs. Am I completely dense? Ah, right, the window's up there. Fair enough. It's okay. I found some patience. I looked. Unlocked the easier way now. Shared bathroom. Shared by crystals. Scared the hell out of me, mold man. I should have guessed that by now, right? And oh god, why? It's with the double button press. New something, right? Another one lost. Unbelievable, man. Why would you do that to me? Let's check the elevator downstairs then. More mold.
Properly trained. Guess I pass. I am very properly trained.
All right, let's try this first then. No way. Jesse Faden, starring in Swift Platform.
After that camera, and step on it.
Don't jump, whatever you do, I guess. Do it, Jesse.
No way am I sharing the spotlight.
Sharing the spotlight. Oh, this is awesome. Skills.
Huh.
Now he's dead anyway. At least they've been kind with not forcing me to start over again. Yeah, we'll hang to the left this time. Third act villain. Classic third act villain. If that was the third act, then this should be the end. That was awesome, man. Wasn't expecting that at all.
Wait, what? We're back? Did that really just happen? It felt like a dream. Or maybe a bad movie.
Oh, did we get something to read there? Movie camera procedures. The item should be Action Max Camera, altered item number 80. The item should be isolated from any person or event that is objectively interesting, since its effect is activated by the presence of dramatic incidents. A movie camera used to make commercial feature films, internal mechanisms are unremarkable. Subjects near the item will often experience a torqued version of reality resembling the heightened drama and action of a movie. Whether these events are localized alternate realities or products of hallucination is currently unknown. Additionally, the item seems to record footage from these incidents and creates VHS copies edited in the style of short films. The background. During their investigation, agents learned that a podcast titled Brian's Movie Den had reviewed the item-generated movie Delivery Disaster. The podcast's creator, Brian Henneman, was taken for questioning. The staff of Movie Night, the store Mr. Henneman rented the film from, were also questioned to no effect. That's really cool. Alright. Picked up a good few ability points from that as well. Let's move on ahead just to see if we pick up a control point. I can go for another 10 minutes in this episode if I need to. No need to smash up the place if we don't have to. Stacks of film in there. I think. Movie camera supplement, the Action Max camera. The item first came to the Bureau's attention after a hospitalized mailman from Redacted Arkansas claimed his injuries had been caused by a movie camera. Further investigation connected the incident to AI-80, which was being shipped in the mail truck at the time. The packaged camera was later found in an empty warehouse. The return address led agents to a P.O. box located in San Fernando Valley belonging to a company called Blessed Pictures. whether Blessed Pictures is involved in the creation and dissemination of the item's VHS films is unknown. The following is a list of all the known films believed to have been shot by AI-80. Shoot First, Die Last, Unreleased, Coffee Bullet, Billy's First Car, Bike Hard, and Delivery Disaster. Item was used in the filming of an unreleased Western in 1968 on the Italian island of Sardinia. A cast member was killed during an on-set accident, stopping production. It's believed that the Blessed Pictures bought the camera when equipment from the shoot was sold at auction. Interesting. Oh, it's another bridge. Shift account, part 3. It's clear no one's coming. We're running out of ideas and supplies. We tried getting into the caves to find anything edible, but all we found were noxious gases and endless pits. Crystals only let us go one way, even though we could see the caves branching out. We did find some weird spiky pillar. I only got a glimpse of it before the astral spikes attacked. There were a few of them this time. We lost a lot of people. Really? There's only 6 of us left. We didn't ask for this. We didn't want to come down here. I'm convinced something brought us here. The others say I'm going nuts, but it's clear that this was no house shift. Shifts slide a bathroom a sector over or rotate a hallway. They don't drop full divisions into some caves. We were brought here, I know it. But for what? Why tear us away from our lives just to torture us? This is some sort of test or mission? Then here's some advice for whoever's running it. Give out clearer instructions next time. I hope these notes are a good read for whatever ranger finds them. Fuck you. Put that in your report, Gibbs. Jeez. I imagine they've shifted again since.
Worst I've ever seen. Hiss, take the nail. End of the world.
So I can't let the hiss take the nail. Not a problem. I know how to handle them.
Right, guys, I'm going to leave the video there before we enter over here. So, yeah, really interesting learning about how this department got lodged down here. Really cool. Really cool. So I'll pick it up from here next time. Hope you enjoyed it. Leave me a thumbs up if you did. Just remember, everyone, never trust an on crate. I'll see you next time.